glorious leader Malcolm Turnbull has shown why he is considered to be the slam dunk champion of the world by conducting a slam dunk in front of a crowd with much wisdom and success. Boom shakalaka!
Okay. Good take. Mm-hmm. Maybe we could lose the Korean outfit, though.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, you're not Korean.
Oh. All right. I was lucky enough to do an internship with Ri Chun-hee. She is the best journalist in North Korea. She's also the only journalist in North Korea, but it's still an achievement. She taught me everything I know. It took about 2 minutes.
A new news poll today shows 46% of Australians think Malcolm Turnbull is a better Supreme Leader than feeble goblin boy Bill Shorten. There was much rejoicing in the streets with the return of Dear Leader's leather jacket. The stock market is up 500% and many are now wearing leather jackets to honour our Dear Leader, including famous movie stars like Jimmy Dean.
I mean, it goes without saying that SBS were all about diversity, but working with Mark has provided some unique challenges.
Hey, Mark, this story about Malcolm Turnbull shooting a basketball, you've written, upon witnessing the strength and accuracy of the Supreme Leader, LeBron James shed many large tears and vowed to never pick up a basketball again. Do you have a source for that statement?
Malcolm's glory is self-evident and does not require sources. Supreme Leader Malcolm Turnbull has lost his 19th straight news poll, cleverly outwitting naysayers who claimed he could only lose 18.
Recently, after some feedback, we decided to take Mark off voiceover duty.
Okay, Mark, we just need you to say the Reserve Bank has maintained interest rates.
Got it.
Great.
The all-knowing Reserve Bank has maintained interest rates because they are perfect and virtuous!
We thought things might improve if we moved Mark to sport. Yeah, well, that didn't work either.
Australia has once again been crowned most charitable nation on earth after donating the Bledisloe Cup to New Zealand for the 15th straight year. Such generosity, great sportsmanship.
Ultimately, we decided to part ways with Mark. There's just no place in the Australian media landscape for that ridiculous one-sided presenting style. I mean, other than Sky News.